Good afternoon, everybody. In view, it is with deep sense of grief that I wish to address the world on what on the candidate that took place in my house yesterday at Ifite Ore Ifite, in the Ekwusigodo government area of Anambra State. And particularly in regard to the safety concern being raised by my fans, friends, colleagues, well-wishers, and members of the Nigerian people of Biafra who are representing all capacity in law. And also to address the false narrative being peddled by the police in Anambra State on the incident of yesterday, it has become compelling that I narrate to the world about what transpired in my house yesterday and how it started. On Sunday, being the first day of December 2019, I was caught at about 8 to 9 p.m. in the night by the DPO of Orifo Police Station. So I never passed any message to me. Then in the morning, at about 6 a.m. in the morning, I got a call from my brother, from my elder brother, Emeke Ejiofor, emergency Emeke Ejiofor, that police has invaded my premises, led by the area commander himself. So I remember I requested to speak with the area commander, and which request was obliged by him. So, and which conversation was fully recorded. I requested to know why they're in my house, because at the time in question, I wasn't around. So they said that they came to arrest one of my wards who participated in a local conflict. Then I ever demanded to see me, and I told him I went somewhere. But I was back around 10:30, 11 o'clock in the morning. That when I come back, I will come to the station to see him personally to find out what transpired, why he's in my house. So he said, okay, that will oblige me that request. But he emphasized that time is of essence. He emphasized that time is of essence, that I should keep to time. So I became worried because I came back since 24th of November 2019 for my brother's burial. And I've been around since that time. The burial was conducted on the 27th of November 2019. We stayed till Sunday when we went for outing service. I never had any issue with anybody. I never stepped out of my house. I've been indoors receiving visitors, sympathizers from all walks of life. So when I came back around 10 o'clock in the morning, I briefly had a discussion with my mother. And I promised him, I told him I was going to see the area commander to find out why they were in my house. So, but on a second thought, I decided to go to see my uncle, who will accompany me in that movement. So I've already left the house to my uncle's place, where I will pick him. And that served as a saving grace to the carnage, to disaster, because the target was me. So I was on my way going to the area commander's office, taking a non-conventional route, when I got a call from my junior brother that the police were in my house, and they've opened fire on all living objects in my house, including all persons in my house. So I was like, somebody came to your house at about 6 o'clock. We had a discussion with him on offenses I don't even know about. And I promised him as a lawyer, well respected, that I'm going to be in the office at about 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. Then what's happening, what's taking place in my house, took me by surprise. So I decided to observe. So I now proceeded from that step, from that movement. And waited until I was further briefed on what was going on. So as the carnage proceeds, my brother kept on furnishing me with developments in my house. And after 2 minutes of our discussion, he told me that about 4 persons have been gunned down in my premises. And the entire house, my entire household set ablaze by the police. So I said, what happened? What's actually going on? Because I was confused. What's actually going on? The police came to my house, opened fire on people living in my house, they found in my house, set my house ablaze, set the house in the neighborhood ablaze. What have I done to deserve this kind of treatment? So I decided to take refuge within the neighborhood. So, and as the carnage progressed, the report kept on filtering in as to what the atrocities that committed in my house, including raping people around the area. So in the end, they took away the 4 cops, dead bodies of people they killed in my house, in their own van, to a place called Market, along on the Tawara Express Road. Burned all of them in their vehicle and left. So that is all transparent. That's all I know I can say at this stage. However, going forward, when I read the police report yesterday, released Anambra State Police Command report yesterday, I was shocked to my marrow. One, the ACP came to my house from Orifite Command at about 6 o'clock and I spoke with him. And I promised him I was gonna be in with him at about 10 a.m. in the morning. 10, 11 o'clock in the morning. At most, I'll be there before 11 o'clock in the morning. Then how come? He said somebody lodged a complaint against me at about 11:30 in the morning. You were in my house at about 6 a.m. in the morning. I had a discussion with you that I'm coming to see you at about between 10 and 11. So how come somebody lodged a complaint against me? Then, assuming without considering to the fact that anybody lodged a complaint against me on a case of abduction and all those frivolous offenses, is that sufficient enough to warrant using force on people they found in my premises, firing at random, killing people there, then, and also burning houses? I'm a lawyer with addresses. I have 2 chambers, one in Abuja, one at Anambra State. And I practice. I'm a very serious legal practitioner. I go to court almost every day. So, not that I'm going to run away from the police. However, it's important for me to emphasize that Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor has maintained more than 17 years unbroken relationship with the police hierarchy. They can attest to that fact at Abuja. They know me as a peace-loving man. They know me as a gentleman of the law. I relate to them in all capacity. I don't look for problem. I am not an enemy of the police. So why should they invest? Why should such thing happen? However, I was also further informed on an investigation that people behind the carnage in my house were one, a controversial businessman in Orifte, who has built library in Kastina, and also schools in Kastina, that he has undertaken from the Fulani Caliphate, that he's the only one that will see to my claim, no matter any means he wants to use, that will see possible for him. That was an assurance and a deal they reached. Because if the intention of the people coming to my house was to arrest me, they wouldn't have done anything. They would barely demand to see me. Or what case scenario? Leave an invitation letter for me to come to the police. This is a person that has spoken with area commander in the morning before the attack incident. They will leave an invitation letter for me to come. Best what case scenario? They have many ways of getting at me. Even if I refuse to report as I was asked to come. They have many ways of reaching me. I can run away from the police because I know I have committed no offense to law. I've committed no offense to law. But the simple reason is because they are actually interested in getting me out of the way. They are actually interested in killing me. Because they have seen me, the government has seen me as a thorn in their flesh. Because I am defending the members of the young people of Biafra and then Abrikan. Because they saw me that any place they arrest any of our IPOB, I'll be there to get them out. And I've been in all courts with them. Abuja, Lagos, Abuja, Port Court, Akwa Ibom, all over the places, Anambra State, Enugu, all over the places, I've been in court with them. And I've been defending them. Officially, all the cases I'm dealing against them. Because IPOB are merely exercising their rights as provided. So they are not terrorist organization. This terrorism tax on them has been effectively challenged in court of appeal, which has been heard and awaiting judgment. So I don't know where I've gone. I've got it wrong. So only a few days ago, I was told which case I'm preparing to go to, that two members of IPOB were gunned down by police at Aaron Zuzo. This is a matter I was planning to go to before they come to my house. So I'm calling on responsible government, international organization, EU, UN, US, and also UK, and also Amnesty International. They get to inform and investigate the carnage in my house. Because as I speak to you, I'm homeless as I speak to you. They burned down virtually everything. And furthermore, it's important to clarify that many people were killed in the process. Now, I learned that many people that were running inside the houses that were burned down. So until when an access is given to people who investigate what transpired in my house, we cannot be able to determine the number of people that were killed. Because I can assure you that over 20 to 30 persons has been murdered in my house on account of this incident. And my mom was also gunned down. My mom was also gunned down. My mom sustained a serious gun injury, and it's a serious treatment. So I don't know the offense I have committed for becoming a lawyer for IPOB. So I don't know why I got this wrong. This is a person that has been at home since Sunday, 24th of November, 2019, till Sunday, 1st of December, 2019, when we went for outing service. So I'm calling on MBA also to intervene. I'm going to do a petition. I've made a contact with MBA local chairman of MBA Abuja branch. Okay, to take it up. But I don't know what I've done. My life is at stake as I speak to you. Because the intention of the assailants is to kill me. Nothing more. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So I want this matter to be speedily investigated. Speedily investigated. Thank you so much. Furthermore, it's important to pass this message to the whole world that if my house will be attacked in this manner, done by the police in conjunction with the military. It shows that there's nobody in the Southeast region who is saved. That was what it means. If my house can be attacked in this manner, and people gone down in this manner, that shows that there's no Southeast person, that there's no Southeast who is serving the hands of the security agents. Right. It's also important to emphasize, no policeman cops was found in my premises. Because I didn't have to say that. Then their vehicle was not found in my premises. Nobody was killed, no police was killed. They took the cops of the people they killed, the civilians they were killing in my house to the expressway, burn them down, and also burn the vehicle. So I am very, very familiar with the workings of the system. Very familiar by virtue of my relationship with the police. I know that if at all that the police is actually investigating those frivolous and smooth criminal allegations against me, what they will have done in the first place. Okay. Thank you so much.
Let's finish.